Now, I know I'm going to get a lot of slack for posting this video, but I have an existing residential client. We've been servicing this ductless mini split system for about 2.5 years, and it's slowly adding up. You see, every year we have to add 1.5 pounds of refrigerant to the system. They don't want to spend the money to replace it or fix it. They just want to gas and go. And today, we're going to do that again.
Ounces. 18,000 BTUs.
There's one, and of course the other one is right there. Let's put those on top of the disconnect. She frozen. She frosted over. She's frosty. All right. Well, at least this is not hand tight. I'm just gonna grab the first wrench that I see. Adjustable. That works. Let's take this off. Let's hook up our gauges. And every time I go to use this, the batteries are dead. If anyone wants a Testo 557 with the low loss hoses, it's for sale. I'm gonna sell this for $300. If you want it, email me, mike@mikeypipes.com. $300 plus some shipping. It's yours. I'm done. I'm done with Testo. Hey, I'm done. I'm done with Testo. My hand hurts, so that's why I'm taking it a little easy today. A little slow. Okay. Purge the air out. And 60 PSI. Yeah, that makes perfect sense if it was R22. All right, got my tank upside down. Purge the air out. Let's add a little bit of refrigerant. This is called instant gratification, ladies and gentlemen. Instant gratification. And look how fast that that frost disappears. All right, I think that's about 1.5 pounds. I'm joking, but the proper way to charge a ductless mini split system is to recover and then weigh in exactly what it needs. Typically for a Fujitsu Mitsubishi, but with some of these inverters, you never know. I installed a Hisense High Ultra yesterday, 18,000 BTU system. It wants the shortest line set as possible. And matter of fact, the control wire that it comes with is only 7 feet long. If you're over 25 feet or 7.5 meters, you gotta add refrigerant. And there's a maximum distance of 80 feet. So every mini split is different, but I got some nice discharge air coming out of here, nice and toasty now. I'm gonna grab my digital psychrometer and we're gonna take a temperature reading out of the condenser outlet. 85.5 degrees, outdoor 66. Not too shabby. We're now extracting heat from inside the home, discharging it outside by means of the copper line set, the evaporator coil, the condensing coil, the inverter, and that's the refrigeration cycle. And let's not forget the metering device. So 86.8.9. Nicey nice. Do you know how old this unit is?
I have to double check. Is it the indoor or the outdoor?
This is the outdoor unit.
Outdoor, okay, give me a moment.
Okay.
It's from 2020.
It's from 2020. Okay. Is it still under warranty?
It lost warranty this year, March.
March.
It just lost warranty. I mean, if you have proof of installation, it might be a later date. Be available.
Where do I get an evaporator coil from? I know this is the outdoor unit. Does that come from you guys, or does it come from a distributor?
No, it has to come through from your distributor. Do you want to open a case?
Well, I have a refrigerant leak in the system. But if it's not under warranty anymore and the homeowner doesn't have proof of purchase, then, you know, the repair costs, right?
Yeah.
So can you give me a local distributor if I give you a zip code?
Where are you located? What state?
New York.
Let me double check.
Okay. I'm on Long Island.
So the thing is, Long Island, we used to have Johnstone. They don't sell our units anymore. So if you're looking for like a new coil or like a new unit, they're not gonna have. You might have to go with North Star Supply. I can give you their number.
You know where they're located?
They're in Rochester.
In Rochester.
Yeah.
Gotcha. And that's the only, is that the other, only other one in New York?
Yeah.
Gotcha.
That's all I have.
What about Jersey or like, because Rochester would be like probably like an 8-hour one-way drive.
Yeah. So Jersey, we do have one of our good distributors, U.S. Supply.
U.S. Supply. Okay, I'll Google it.
Okay. Okay. No problem.
All right. Thank you so much for your help. I appreciate it. Thank you. Bye. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is why you don't buy internet brand equipment. Now, you may see me install internet brand equipment for my clients, but at the end of the day, a product is only as good as the support that you can get from the manufacturer. And we're condensing away. Wait for it. There you go. I never looked at the outdoor coil. Yeah, not terrible. All right, system is still cooling. Total time on site, almost 51 and a half minutes. Overall, nice clean install. If we had another 20 minutes, we could probably give her a nice clean bath. But gas and go, it doesn't take 20 minutes. Takes an hour. Thank you. You have any questions for me?
No. If you said they could email me a copy of the receipt.
Yeah, I'm gonna email you what I wrote down as well here. So, because you need to sign this.
Yeah.
As documented during the December 2024 service call, the single zone ductless mini split system is low on refrigerant. This means there's a leak in the system and the issue will not go away. And then I keep going and talk about what's there.
Yeah, as long as it's there so I don't have to memorize everything.
Everything's there, but keep in mind there's absolutely no warranty or guarantee on what I did. I provided instant gratification for you.
Yeah, I just needed it.
Please sign at the bottom with your finger. Thank you very much. No, you're good.
So it should work now for a little bit, right?
It should, yes. The credit card receipt was just sent to you. And I'm emailing you your paid receipt for the invoice that documents everything right now. I'm gonna mark it paid first, hold on.
Just curious, what brand do you
We install Fujitsu. Yeah.
You only install those?
We from time to time do install internet brands. Daikin? We've installed a few of them. Any particular reason why you like them, or why you mentioned them?
No, I just know someone that has them.
Okay, they have a showroom, a nice fancy multi-million-dollar showroom right down the block in Valley Stream.
I saw. I'm letting go in. I'm
Just it's
has
a lot of I don't want to talk bad about them, but a lot of these manufacturers smoke and mirrors. But they make it's, at the end of the day, a lot of the stuff is made in the same plant in China.
Yeah,
and the plant is the size of Long Island. I'm not exaggerating. These are massive mega factories, and every single brand makes the same, puts a different label on it. But when you need a part, it's you can't go to like the manufacturer. You have to go to the, like, here it's Comfort Star. Like Fujitsu, like there's probably 100 distributors in a, I don't know, a half hour drive. Seriously, like there's massive, they're massive, I guess, branding. They're everywhere, you know. So
what, a lot of places sell their parts.
Yes. And the warranty is not, you know, a couple years, 5 years. It's like 6, 7, 10 years, 12 years. So, but the problem here is, and you're going to run into this soon. Well, I don't know when to, I don't wish to mean bad, is that that copper line is going to have to be replaced. And that wall is going to have to get opened up.
Yeah.
There's no other way around it.
No, I'm painfully aware, but because of her, that's why we didn't. Yeah. She was a lot younger then. Like, you know, we just didn't want to do that big job in the winter.
Yeah. You know what I mean? Now, maybe this will last for the rest of the cooling season, and but don't neglect, you know, don't do this in the winter, like and when it's January, you know, January.
Yeah, to let it go.
December or February, you know, when it's like 10 degrees outside and you need to do this kind of job. Mm-hmm. Do it, you know, plan ahead and you'll be all right.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, I appreciate that. Thank
you,
man.
Nice day.
Thank you, too. Thank you. Set that to a number that's good for her.
Oh,
okay.
I will.
Thank you.